shiresociety.com.
All right, so it's December 5th, 2 days after the Penrose Public Library in Colorado Springs kicked me out and wouldn't let me film an anti-Trump event that was going on in the public library. So I've made one of these, and I'm going to take it and wave it in front of the library. By now you may have seen all or some of the videos I shot of that incident 2 days ago. That's the library there. So this apparently is allowed on library property. Civic activity, not so much.
Alright, so this is video from earlier in the series, from the actual incident. If you watch the series from the beginning, you'll see it. But there have been some additional developments in relation to this incident that I wanted to share with you. First, on December 8th, 5 days after this video was shot, I received an email from YouTube stating that the first three videos in the series, an individual has filed a complaint about them and asked YouTube to take them down. It's referred to as a privacy complaint. I had been planning on doing nothing else after this protest. This little protest was going to be the last thing I did in relation to this issue, other than uploading the videos. However, because of the censorship, the external or remote censorship attempt, the PR war resumes, limited in scale though it may be. So what I've done is to start uploading the videos to other services. I made a call to talk radio about it, and I've written a letter to the editor for the Gazette Telegraph. Later I plan to write one for the CS Indy. Those are the two Colorado Springs papers. Now, I don't know for sure that the library personnel made the attempt to take down the videos, but I don't know of anyone else that would have a motive, and they've definitely already done enough to me to justify me taking these additional steps. Also, previously, before the remote censorship attempt, I did contact the organization that was holding the anti-Trump event there, the anti-Trump event I never saw a frame of because I was kicked out so soon. I informed them what had happened to me before they started to arrive. On their Facebook page for the event, the group is called Unite Colorado Springs. It seems to be a Democrat-leaning group. They were basically it looked like three Democrat politicians or officials who were going to be present or speaking there that they had named. And they said on their Facebook page, quote, "All perspectives are welcome, but we ask that participants be respectful to those who may have differing views," unquote. Fair enough. So I emailed them and I said, hey, yeah, I noted your indication that all would be welcome.
Complying, but you weren't complying with what I asked.
Which part was I not complying with?
You're refusing to put down your camera.
But I did not feel welcome by your venue. So they responded to me as follows. Quote, "Hi, Dave. We were not aware of this issue with the venue, and I will get in contact with you directly," unquote. That was on roughly December 6th. Right now, as I'm reading this, it's December 10th. I've not yet heard back from them. But what did happen is right after I emailed them, I lost my ability to see their Facebook page when logged in. So take that for what it's worth, or whatever it implies. I can see it when I'm not Ridley. When I'm Ridley, it's hidden from me. I posted my same concerns to their page, not their event page, but their main page, and those concerns were not taken down as of 3 days later. I can't think of anything else to mention. That's where things currently stand.
The old world is collapsing, and it's going to take its slave driver governments with it. But what will rise up in their place? In New Hampshire, the Shire Society has a plan and a history of action.
He didn't take long to come up with a plan.
You can sign up right now at
ShireSociety.com.